Welcome to MooMooMath and subtracting integers. If you're using counting chips and you are solving subtraction problems, you have two options. Option one is, when subtracting, you can represent each number following the subtraction sign with a zero pair and then work the problem with the counting chips, or you can change the subtraction sign to addition and change the sign to the number right after the subtraction sign. Let's look at some example problems. In this video, I'd like to work on subtracting integers that are positive and negative. And in order to do that, I'm going to use counters, but you can tell I don't have counters, but I'm going to use nickels and pennies, and the nickel will be the positive number because 5 cents is more positive than 1 cent. And the penny is negative, and whenever you have a positive and negative together, they cancel each other, and we're going to call that a zero pair. Okay. Now, whenever we have, like, let's look at the first example. We have 4 minus a negative 3, and a lot of times we get confused. What do you do with this negative? So I'm going to show you 2 techniques to solve this, and then you can decide which one you like best. I'm going to first put down 4 positive numbers. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 positive numbers. Well, when I go to subtract a negative 3, there's nothing to subtract. So what some people do is they go ahead and let a zero pair represent, I'm going to move this over, a zero pair represent the negative number. So I can do a zero pair, okay? And so, because a zero pair equals zero, and then I can now subtract, since I have some negative numbers, I can subtract them. So I will take these 3 numbers away, minus 3, and I'm left with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 positive. So it equals 7. The method that I prefer, but you can use either one, is what you do is whenever you are subtracting a negative number, you change the sign to positive and then change the sign of the number directly behind the subtraction sign to the opposite. And so now I'll use my counters. I will do 4 positive, and then I have 3 more positive, and you will see I now have a grand total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 positive numbers. So you get the same. Let's go ahead and work the next one. We have minus 3, which is a negative minus 4. So I'm going to begin by putting down 3 negative numbers. But now I need to subtract 4. But I do not have anything to subtract. So I'm going to put down a zero pair. So there's 1 zero, and I'm going to have to put down 4 zero pairs because it needs to be 4 positive. Okay? And there's 2, 3, and then here's my 4th zero pair. And now I subtract 4 positives. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, and I'm left with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 negative numbers. Okay, negative 7. If you haven't picked up by now, I prefer this second method, but you can use either one. I have a negative number and a subtraction, so what I will do is just simply change the sign and then change the sign of the number directly behind the subtraction. I now put down 1, 2, 3 negatives for this number, 4 negatives here. It is an addition problem, so what do I have? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 negative numbers, minus 7. Okay, let's go ahead and work 5 minus a negative 2. I'm going to go ahead and change the subtraction to a positive, to an addition, and then change the sign of the number directly behind the subtraction sign, so that becomes a 2. I will put 5 counters for the first number, which is 5, 2 for the second number, and that gives me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and that equals positive 7. Okay, and let's go ahead and work this last example. We have 2 minus a negative 3. And so, before I get started, you know, if you like the counters and you're completing a test, you know, I'm just using nickels and pennies. You could literally get a sheet of paper, and if before the test you could tear it, and you could literally just, if this would help, you could just write a positive on one sheet of paper, and then, see, I'm just tearing it, but it would still work as counters, and just do a negative on the other. And if you like using the counters, when you're working a test or working problems like this, you could just make some homemade counters very quickly and use that. Okay, so let's go ahead and use the last one. As I stated previously, I like to just change the sign. I have a negative number and subtraction, so I will go 2, change the sign to positive. The number directly behind it becomes a positive 3. I will put the counters down. Remember, my nickel is more positive than a penny, so I will put 2 for this side, and then I will, so here's 2, 1, 2, and then I will do 3 on the other side, and when I total that, I get a positive 5, okay? Again, very quickly, if you don't like that method, what I would do for the negative number, if you don't want to change the sign, I put a 0 pair down for each negative number, and then all I do from there is subtract the negatives, and you'll notice that you get the same answer of 5. Hope this helps with subtracting integers. Remember, MooMooMath uploads a new math video every day.